For decades, Oskar Morawetz was Canada's most successful composer, both at home and abroad. That is, if you measure success by the number of performances and by the caliber of the musicians who were attracted to his work.
I remember a while back, this is several years ago, he made out a list. By the way, I don't think I was alone in receiving regularly from him lists of his recent performances. So I was better acquainted with what he was doing than with almost all of his colleagues. But at one point, there was a list of over 120 orchestras that had played Oskar Morawetz pieces. I doubt very much any other so-called serious Canadian composer could have put forward a list to match it. Partly that was the nature of the music itself. It was accessible. It was immediately emotionally accessible. And so, therefore, people wanted to play it. But there was also the fact that he went out and took the effort of introducing himself to conductors and to musicians and to make them aware of his music. And I think composers are always complaining, and perhaps legitimately so, that the musical industry doesn't do enough to promote their cause. Oskar was conscious of the fact that if he didn't do some of the work himself, it wouldn't be done. And he did. He went backstage to congratulate people and said, by the way, I have this, and would you like to look at it? And they did. And some of those pieces consequently were played. But when you have conductors of the stature of William Steinberg, Raphael Kubelik, Carol Anscherl wanting to play your music, it's not just because you've had a smile on your face when you've come to shake hands backstage. It's because you have something to offer.
Master. If I were wealthy, I would have his works performed. And if you see what the young composers are writing now, it's Oskar's music is not that conservative, and it's coherent and strong.
His compositions are outstanding. I would hope that, and that is one of his great fears, is that when he's gone, that his compositions will disappear and that people aren't going to play them anymore.
Well, I would like to see that his works are continue to be played, and not just the well-known ones, not the Anne Frank and the Martin Luther King and the Carnival Overture, which everybody plays. You know, as I go through his music now and see there's some works I'd never even heard of before, you know, they must have been played once or twice and never again. Just to be remembered as a really well-known composer, and also as a person. You know, you say there's a lot of people who joke about how he was a morbid or whatever kind of person, but I would hope that people also remember him, you know, especially close friends and family, as a very kind and caring kind of person. You know, he really loved his friends and really looked out for them and, you know, wanted people to feel good and not upset. And so, you know, as a man, a nice, kind, serious person, and for his music to be played and to be remembered as, you know, a really great Canadian composer.